Canva has a pretty extensive library of photos and videos that are available for your designs. And by using some of the built-in editing tools, you can get really creative with them. So I'm going to show you 5 different effects using these tools that will help take your content to the next level. My name is Kat, and this is Canva Caturday. For our first effect, we are going to merge 2 images together. So here is my first image, and then here is the second image, and we're going to blend these 2 together. And basically what we're going to do is create a masking effect so that we can blend those 2 photos. So I just did a search for white gradient, and Canva gave me these search results. I'm going to click on this one right here where it says white transparent gradient, and we're going to use that one. So you're going to add that to the design. Next, you want to rotate it so that whatever side of the image you want to mask, the white part is on that side. So you can see I've got this white part. This is the section I want to mask off. So I'm going to just make this a little larger. Now, one thing with these gradients, they usually don't go to completely opaque white. If you see right here, you can still kind of see a little bit of her eye right there. So in order to fix that, all you have to do basically is just duplicate this gradient a couple times. So I'm going to bring it to right about there so that my gradient is just past the halfway point, and then duplicate it a couple times and just bring it over and duplicate it maybe 2 or 3 times so that the entire one side is nice and opaque. Let me just detach the background for a minute. And I'm going to grab all of these gradients. You see, I made 4 copies that gave me that nice opaque portion. And I'm going to group them together because it's going to be easier to move them around. Grab my foreground and put that back. Next, I'm going to grab the group of gradient images, and I'm simply going to copy them, Command C or Control C on your keyboard, and paste them into the other image. And then you just want to rotate it to put it on the opposite side. So I'm going to flip it around like that. And then I'm just going to bring it over to this side. So now on this image, I have the right side is masked, and on this image, the left side is masked. Next, just download them to your device. So click share and download. I like to bring the size up a little bit because we're going to download this a second time in a moment, and I want that image to be nice and crisp. So I'm just bringing it up to a size of 2. That increases my resolution just a little bit. Click download. And then you're going to bring them right back into Canva. So let me go grab that download. Here we go. We're going to bring both of these images right back in. Once they're back in, you're going to add a new page. I'm going to add the background image first. Bring that like this. And then I'm going to add the foreground image. Bring this up like that. And next, you want to take this foreground image and bring down the transparency. So click on the transparency button. Depending on the type of image you're using, you have a little bit of play here. I would say anywhere between 40 and 60% is good. Let's see. Let's bring it to, I'm going to bring it to 50. I think that's probably good for this photo. So I can evenly see both portions of that image. And then you want to download it one more time. Click share, click download. Once again, I like to increase the size, so I'm bringing that back up, and then click download. You're going to bring this one back into Canva again. Go grab it. I only need the last one. Here we go. Bring it back in. We're going to add a new page. Bring in the merged image like that. And next you want to click and where it says edit photo, and we're going to make some adjustments here. Click on adjust. What you're going to work with here is brightness, contrast, vibrance, and saturation. So for brightness, you want to bring that down just a little bit. And for contrast, you want to bring that up a little bit. Right about there. And then vibrance, you can play with this one and bring that up. And then saturation, and bring that one up. Bring the vibrance a little more. And there you go. You've just merged those 2 images together. This is a really neat effect, especially if you have something that's like a product or a service and you want to show a couple things side by side. I really like this one. effect number two, we're going to create a blurred background effect, but our subject is going to remain nice and crisp. So find a photo that has a clear subject in the front and duplicate it. Next, you're going to go to edit photo and remove the background of that front photo. You can see that background's been removed. I'm just going to move that over to the side. Click on the background image. And this time you want to go down here to where it says blur right there. We're going to choose this. And you can adjust the intensity to your liking. I think I'll bring this up just a little bit, sort of like that. And then just take the foreground image and bring it directly on top. And now you have that nice effect where you've got your subject and the front is nice and clean, but that background is kind of blurred. Our next effect is called a color isolation effect. And that's when you take portions of your image and keep them as color, but the rest of your image is black and white. And this is really, really neat. So click on your image and once again, duplicate that image. And once again, we are going to choose background remover. Now on the background image, you want to go up here to the adjustments, right here at the very top, click on adjust, and go down to where you see vibrance and saturation right here. And we're going to bring these two sliders all the way down. And it's basically going to take all of that color out of our photo to make it a black and white photo. And then you just take the foreground image and bring it directly on top like that. And now you have a color isolation photo. Our next effect is really cool because you can also do color isolation on videos. I love this one. So here I have a video. I'm going to duplicate it once again, just like I did a moment ago, and click edit video. And I'm going to remove the background on my video because yes, you can remove the background from videos in Canva. So click background remover. You can see that background's been taken away. See, it's gone. On the image right here, I am now going to make some adjustments. Now, the editing tools that are available for videos is different from photos. You do have some more editing tools with photos than in videos. For this one, we're going to click where it says filters and click see all. At the very bottom of filters, you can see there's an option here that says grayscale. That's the one we're going to choose. And it's going to make that background video in grayscale. And then you just take the foreground video and you're going to drag it directly on top. And then watch what happens when we play this. It's really cool. You've got that really neat color isolation where you've got your subject in the front is in color, but your background is in black and white. For our last effect, we're going to switch to the old photo editor. So Canva currently has two different editors. One is the new editor and one is the old editor. And some of the apps that were available in the old editor are not yet available in the new one. So we're going to switch. And yes, you can switch back and forth. So click on your photo and click edit photo. And down here, you'll see you are using the new photo editor. To use the old experience, click here. That's what we're going to do for this effect right here. So click here. You're going to get a pop-up screen. It's going to tell you that you're using the new one. Do you want to keep it or do you want to revert for this effect? We're going to revert back. And how you tell whether or not you're using the old editor or the new one is right up here. If it says edit image, you're using the old editor. If it says edit photo, you're in the new editor. So we know we're in the old one. We're going to now click edit image and we're going to make some adjustments. But before we do that, we have to duplicate our photo. So let's duplicate the photo because we're going to do some fun things here. On this photo, we want to remove the background, our foreground image, take the background away again. There we go. That background's been removed. For the background image we have here, we're going to use one of these apps down here. There's a whole bunch of different apps that are available in the old editor that not yet are available in the new one. So we're going to go down to Paint Effects and click on See All. You have some really neat effects here that kind of make it look like watercolor or stencil. They're really, really cool. I'm going to choose this one right here that says Windel or Windle or Windle, however you want to say that. We're going to use that one. You're going to click on this and it's going to take that background image and make it look like a watercolor on canvas. This is a really neat one. Then you simply take your foreground image that we changed, bring it on top and line it up. And now you have this really cool sort of mixed media effect with this photo. You've got that nice, crisp, modern image in the foreground with that sort of muted watercolor canvas in the background. I like this one a lot. If this was helpful, be sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. That's all for this week. See you next time.